I'm always amazed by how life can pick itself up again after a disaster, especially human life. People have a way of rebuilding, and now we have the chance to build something better. My name is Daisy. I live on Hope Prairie Community. We're a subsistence farm in the Yahara Watershed. I moved here a couple of years ago with my husband, Felix, but actually I was born in Madison 35 years ago, before the disaster. So Yahara is my homeland. Felix and I came here because we wanted to start a new life. We had lived on the climate change refuge for nearly our entire lives, and we were tired of the restrictions of life there. To us, Yahara seemed like a promised land. The disaster cut Yahara off from the rest of the country. No fuel, no government, no social support systems. We are doing everything on our own. But at least this gives us a clean slate for starting again. We live a resourceful and self-sufficient life on Hope Prairie. We grow most of our own food. We have a handful of cows and a herd of goats, which we raise on pasture. We use draft horses and our hands to do all the farming. It's backbreaking, but satisfying work. We trade our dairy products with other farms and some of the urban communities for the things we can't grow, make, or do for ourselves. Bartering has replaced money here, especially since material wealth is pretty much non-existent. But at least that puts most of us on a level playing field. I was only one when my mother and I fled Yahara after the disaster. In the years leading up, a food crisis had hit the United States, which put a lot of pressure on Midwestern farmers to provide food to the country. Yahara's farms became consolidated, and they used a lot of fertilizers and chemicals to keep up with production. This caused a ton of runoff into the lakes. But given the food crisis, the runoff was the least of people's concerns, or so they thought. Mom said it was the runoff that caused the disaster. The runoff made it possible for toxic bacteria to invade the lakes. The bacteria emitted a poisonous fume that killed thousands of people and made thousands of others flee the area forever. The only people who stayed were those who couldn't afford to leave. And then there are people like me and Felix, who came here for the opportunity to start anew. We're reminded of the disaster every summer. The bacteria still live in the lakes, but we just stay away from them in the summer so that we don't breathe in the fumes. It is too bad we can't swim then. Summers can be so unbearably hot. With so few people here now, Yahara is wild, almost prehistoric. Prairies, forests, and wetlands are growing back, and we have so much wildlife. Cougars, wolves, beavers. The oddest is the elephants. Apparently, they escaped from the zoo after the disaster. Funny enough, they are just replacing the mastodons that lived here thousands of years ago. Yahara's wildness doesn't faze my husband. He's the adventurous type. He swims in Lake Wabisa whenever he gets the chance. And when it's not too dangerous to swim, of course. Looking around the watershed now, I can only imagine what life was like here before the disaster. The ruined buildings and remnants of neighborhoods give me some sense of the past. But the people of Yahara are really trying to move on from the past and create a better future.